Well, I appreciate you taking the time to visit with us.
No problem.
Hey, we're out here in front of Walmart and Belle Meade.
Can I say this, though? Now, since you say I can give my opinion.
Oh, absolutely.
From a religious standpoint, I think, now, this is my religious standpoint. I'm not going to say definite, but from a religious standpoint, I think that we'll actually enter into some of the biblical prophecies, where biblical prophecies talking about where we enter into this mark of the beast system. And when you begin to look at some of this stuff, I think a lot of this stuff is going to happen no matter who's in the White House.
Well, now let me ask you this. You talk about religion. Right now, the liberal agenda of Obama and his administration, they're trying to take God out of the Constitution, trying to take it out of the pledge, you know, everywhere you look, they're trying to remove God. How do you feel about that? I mean, this is
my personal opinion. I don't think that you can remove God from a nation that was built off a biblical background. When you look at our society, the way it was produced, it was produced from the Ten Commandments. You know, whether people know it or not, we all keep the Ten Commandments, most of it. Mm-hmm. Now, we may have different opinions, but when you look at it, I can't go to your house and steal.
Right.
So now I may say, well, I'm not religious, but this country was based off that, because the Bible says, well, thou shouldn't steal, so I can't steal. Bible says thou shouldn't kill. We got laws against killing. So when you look at this, we are keeping the Ten Commandments, whether we don't know it or not, at least most of it.
Right.
Because it was built off of a biblical society or a biblical background.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, and we all know that the Lord wants us to prosper.
Yes, sir.
You know, I think that...
Legally.
Legally, exactly. Well, what's happening now is, you know, our tax dollars are getting spread. I mean, they're getting pulled deeper and deeper. They're taking more and more. And that seems to me to kind of go against the grain as to what our country was founded on.
I agree.
And, you know, I think based on what you're telling me, you're more conservative than liberal, for sure.
More conservative.
And
I am conservative.
And in this day and age, I'm going to tell you that means that's Republican. That's not Democrat.
Hey, that's the side that I fit on. That's where I'm at.
That's where you're at.
I am conservative to the max. I don't believe in wasteful spending. I don't believe in that I should force someone to do something. Now, I don't believe in abortion, but I don't think I have to twist your arm or shoot someone to not do it. I would tell you my opinion. It is up to the individual what they do, but I don't want my tax dollars going there. Not just my.
Well, I don't know if you're not, but in the health care,
it's in there.
It's in there. And now your tax dollars are going.
There's a lot.
And guess who put that in place?
Hey, you got to call us.
So that's why it's so important to vote.
Yes,
we got to vote.
It's definitely important. And when you look at this stuff, what kind of future do our kids have?
Oh, gosh.
You know, so that's what I look at it from the long standpoint. What kind of future do she have?
Mm-hmm.
If all our tax dollars is going to other different places.
And then the education system, they're teaching them,
nothing.
You know.
Either they're not teaching them anything.
Teaching them, well, what they
how
are
to take
teaching
a tax
them,
test.
What they are teaching them is they've got books on homosexuality.
Susie got two.
Exactly.
Billy got two dads.
Two dads.
So when you look at it from a standpoint, I'd like her to know that, you know what, it's between a man and a woman. Now, what you do on your side is your business, but don't force that on me.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
If I'm not into homosexuality, don't force it on me. But I'm not going knocking on your door to see what you're doing. That's your business. That's between you and your partner, and then that's between you and God whenever he come back.
Well, hey, since I've got you, and you're already just a wonderful interview, but were you on Fort Hood when that shooting happened?
No, sir. I was stationed at Fort Hood. Actually, that what brought me to Texas was my first news station. Was Fort Hood.
Oh, yeah.
And that was back in 81.
What's the temperature of everyone on the base about that guy, that terrorist?
Well, they don't like it. And, you know, nowadays, people are more, I guess, you know, savvy to what they say, that, you know, because of political correctness.
Mm-hmm.
People don't want to sometimes say what they really feel. I think that the guy, when he ran across Holland, what he was hollering, he told you exactly what he was. He was a terrorist.
Mm-hmm.
Now, like they say, all Muslims aren't terrorists. But when you check it out, all terrorists has been what? Muslims. Just point to the plane.
Well, I'll tell you, it's been a pleasure talking to you.
Yes,
and
sir.
When you get some time, I want you to go to our website, and I'll give you my card.
Okay.
GOPisforme.com. It is a conservative movement, and we focus on Hispanic issues and things like that. But you know, we're about everybody.
Okay.
We're about everybody, and so we need to keep in touch. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Yes, sir.
Okay.